painted the lotuses.
So this is the back with the shiny over it. These two pieces, these have dried. These are the two side panels, they're drying.
The question I'm facing now is, do I attach the shimmery pieces to the skirt pieces so they're all treated as one piece like I did for the bodice? Or do I treat them separately? Put the skirt pieces together and the shimmery pieces together and only attach them at the top, which means that I will have to hem it all separately. And I just don't know. There's gonna be so much fabric for the skirt pieces. However, I could cut down on the amount of fabric of the shimmery and only use two of these panels because there is so much extra.
So if you can see, here's the edge of the material, and this is how much of this is left over.
And it's gonna be like that for all of them. So I could just take two of the shimmery panels for the skirt, attach those, and then attach all three of the pieces for the skirt in the regular fabric, I guess, and get all of those pieces put together and hemmed. Then attach them at the tops and then attach that to the bodice so that the skirts kind of billow around each other a bit. Why did I do this to myself? It's gonna look great once it's done. I'm just in those stages where I am, my mind is going 1,000 miles a minute with so many things, not just this, but just so much right now, and it's so hard to quiet it down. Anxiety. It is not your friend. Okay. I might have to take a moment and walk away and just kind of clear my mind, which I seem to have to be doing a lot of lately from anything. Okay, it is almost 8 o'clock. I've been at this since about 11 o'clock this morning, and several horrible sewing mishaps later, I have realized the thread I was using is stretchable. It is a stretchy, elasticy type of thread, which is why it was puckering. And I realized this when I was trying to sew my regular fabric, and it was doing the exact same thing as the sheer fabric, and then my needle broke. Thankfully, I had the other purple thread that's all purpose, so fixed. But then I had to rip some seams out and start again. Got one of the side panel of the skirts sewn to the back. Got my sheer sort of fixed. Went to sew the other side panel to the back. I realized I have sewn it to the other side panel. So it is in the wrong place. And I am taking this as a sign to stop and walk away, because I am devastated. I know it sounds weird to say that, but it's so disheartening. That's what it was. It was disheartening. And I've just been so anxious all day, and I did it to myself. But now the anxiety is kind of riding high, so I'm just gonna walk away from it. I'm gonna take my mind off of it, watch something, read something, I don't know, but just take time away and sit and be quiet for the rest of the evening, and then hopefully can pick it up again with a clearer mind. Well, I fixed the panels, so now you can
See, I've just kind of pinned it on here to see how it's going to sit. I need to hem it, but I'm afraid I'm going to have to hem it after I've attached it. I was hoping to hem it ahead of time, but just not going to know where it'll sit until I've attached the pieces. Same thing with the shimmery. But feeling a little better about it now, so crisis averted. One more piece that I think I need to make a Yunmeng Jiang costume complete, of course, is a clarity bell. On a whim, I found something on Amazon that I bought. It's this little thing that you can see the lotus on it, and I don't know if you can hear this. But it does have a bell in it. The other thing I found were these tassels that have little lotuses on them as well. So I can make this, and then I just have to figure out how to attach it. What I'm thinking is to go with the Regency style that I'm using, I can create a reticule, those little bags that they did, and somehow attach this to the bottom of that. I'll have to get rid of some of this extra string. But that's my thought, because I do have extra fabric, so I could use it to create such a bag. So we'll see. But I am so pleasantly pleased with finding this little bell. All right, at a bit of a weird angle, because I'm trying to get the entire thing in the shot. But this is where we're at. Everything is put together. I've already added a little bit of trim up here on the black. So now it's adding the trim to the purple. I've got to figure out how much more I need to take it up so that I can walk without tripping over it. But I think overall, I am pleased with where it's at. So I have attached the CDN to itself, the ring to the snake. Apparently a lot of people have found this snake online and used it for the same thing, because I was looking for something else and stumbled across a bunch of people who had done this, so I'm in good company. Yay! But I couldn't leave well enough alone, because I needed it to do something. So I found a fiber optic whip that can be in purple. I can turn it on and off. So, I can't do too much with it right now. I've got a lot of stuff around my apartment to be able to actually whip things. But it does move. The top of it is flexible so that you can whip it if you would like. And obviously, unlike an actual whip, it's a little bit unruly towards the end, so to actually do a really good flick is not going to happen. I'm just going to wind up whipping myself. But for just purposes of having the proper accoutrement, yes. So once I build my reticule to attach the clarity bell to, I'm going to have to make it large enough to hold this in it so that I can be carrying it around with me without having to have it in my hands constantly. Because obviously, CDN does not turn into this constantly. So I would only need to pull it out when necessary. I can't stop. I'm trying to do it as much justice as I can, although the trash bag has already clicked in and I am already looking at this and looking at everything I've bought and I've done with it and already telling myself that this is crap and not very good and I could have done better and I messed this up and I messed this up, etc., etc., but that is the way trash brain works. I'm trying not to listen to it. I am overall pleased. Anyway.
So I did a thing, and I tried to figure out eye makeup. This is sad. Yeah. Can you tell makeup is not something I normally do? Maybe a little blush. Usually I'll just use the blush as my eyeshadow. Little powder, little mascara, done. I mean, if you watch my other videos, you know I am very minimalist when it comes to my makeup. But I thought, hey, I've made these costumes, why not try and have some fun? And I mean, look, is it the worst thing ever for a first attempt? No, and I am serious. This is my first attempt with this tutorial that I watched on how to do a cut crease. Yeah, so I didn't even know what a cut crease was until I was watching this. This is how little about makeup I know. I know how to do stage makeup, which is kind of what I feel like I've done right now with my eyes. Because I feel like you would see me across a room and it would look like someone punched me in the face. I don't know. It's hard for me to be objective. Also, I have royally screwed up putting on these false eyelashes. But again, I don't use them. So, thankfully I bought a large pack of them so I can keep attempting. My costumes are almost done, so I can't really sew anymore tonight because my eyes were just not wanting to do it. So I decided to try this instead.
It is done. Finally. Here it is in all its glory.
Fingers crossed, if things are going well, between the time I'm filming this and when I'm posting this, I will physically be in San Diego at Comic-Con when this goes up. I didn't chronicle the final stages of my Regency Yunmeng Jiang sect outfit, and I didn't chronicle anything about the Star Wars one that I did because that was a super last minute decision, which you can tell. I kind of plan on just testing that one out at Comic-Con and seeing how it goes, and if all goes well, then I will do a better version of it in the future. So my plan, I am being ambitious this year because I haven't done a lot of costuming the past few times I've gone to Comic-Con, and obviously no costuming whatsoever in the past couple of years because I haven't been going anywhere or doing anything for obvious reasons. I'm gonna try to hit 3 days, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Generally speaking, most of the bigger fandoms have a specific day where you dress up for those fandoms. I'm not really gonna pay attention to that. It could get me looked at funny, but whatever. A lot of it's going to come down to the weather. I already know lots of people, spaces, masking, the anxiety issues that have been off the charts for me lately. It's already going to be a challenge, and then to think of putting on something that's going to be super warm as well. I'm gonna have to take all that into account, but I am going to try. I will attempt the impossible, as we are saying, from the Yunmeng Jiang sect. So take inspiration from that outfit even more. So my plan is Thursday to wear a Regency version of Rogue from X-Men based on this version, which is the version I know best, mostly because of the cartoon and the comics that came out around that time. Problem being with this, the dress itself, not that heavy. But I have long green gloves that go up to about right here, and then yellow gloves to go over those, because of course, she doesn't show skin. And a jacket that is Regency era inspired. And so it just gets super hot. And I did wear it to a Labyrinth of Jareth 1 year which happens in August, and it was still about 80 degrees at night, and then you're inside ballrooms with all these people and the heat that comes off of them. It was a lot for me, because I don't tolerate heat well, as I have said multiple times. We'll see. But that's the plan. Friday, I plan to do my Regency-inspired Yunmeng Jiang sect outfit. And then Saturday, I plan on doing my Regency-inspired Star Wars. Those are the plans. Plans could change. I could scrap it all and just wind up wearing normal clothes on any of those given days, or all of them. It really just kind of depends on my state of being, because as much as I am looking forward to going to Comic-Con again, I am completely anxiety-ridden and nervous about it as well. It is going to be like going for the first time almost all over again. And then, of course, there's the whole pandemic thing. I am very much cognizant of the fact that we are going when there is an upsurge again. There are new variants that are extremely virulent, on the rise. I have my masks. Name a letter with a 95 after it. I have it. I plan on taking some cloth masks as well. Doing everything I can, have a big box of Purell, little single hand thingies. I'll do what I can, but I know what happened to me mentally for the first year and a half of this pandemic, where I completely isolated myself, and I can't go back there. I am trying to get myself acclimated to being around people again, and I really want to go to Comic-Con. I love it. I've been going for over 10 years, over a decade now, and it's one of the highlights of my year. It's something that I can look forward to. It's something I can plan on. It's something that I know is going to be there. It's you know, we all have to have something, right, to kind of look forward to, and for me, one of those things is Comic-Con. We'll see. I plan to do some videos while I'm there, little just short videos here and there, probably talk a little bit about my experience and then compile those into a main video to post, mostly just for me, just so I can chronicle it, and I guess look back on it a few years later and see where I was at and what I was doing, and yeah. So, needless to say, if we wind up for some reason not getting to go, this video will never air, but if it does, then that means I am at Comic-Con. So, until next time.